better half of 50 years is there in bed, and you're praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. You looked at me and said, let's start putting first things first. Cause when your hourglass runs out of sand, you can't rip it over and start again. Take every breath God gives you for what it's worth. Don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap and wake up and you're 25 and your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't wait, you just might miss your babies growing like mine did, turning into moms and dads. Next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there and then. And you're praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend. 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't wait. So I've been trying to take you, and this here today, gone tomorrow world we're living in. Don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap and wake up and you're 25 and your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink. You just might miss your babies growing like mine did, turning into moms and dads. Next thing you know, you better have a 50 years there and then. Praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. No, don't blink.
Bunch of crazy kids. Look at all the things we did. Never thought it'd end like this.
Wake up!
Playing in the high school band. Never really had a plan. Made it to the promised land.
So here's a toast to me and you and every single show. Here's a toast.
Living fast, but always dancing slow.
Here's a toast
to saying yes whenever I said no. What a crazy ride it's been.
Oh,
we may never be best friends. For a couple hours we can. For a couple hours we intend.
So here's a toast
to me and you and every single show.
Here's a toast
to living fast but always dancing slow.
Here's a toast
saying yes whenever I said no.
Let's sing one more song for the memories.
Life's too short to be enemies.
If this ends tonight, you can save your tears for the other guy.
I'll see you.
I swear I
am.
Thanks for the sunrise. Thanks for the night sky. Thanks for the deepest blue in my daughter's eye. And thanks for the weekend. Thanks for a good friend. Thanks for in the high life again. Makes me feel alive. It's been too long since we sat down and talked this way. Life is hard, sometimes I don't know what to say. But thank you,
thank you.
I was 19. Maybe I just miss having things all figured out. Cause now I got doubts and I got these questions. Things I just don't understand. But I bet you'll sort it out. It's been too long since we sat down and talked this way. Life is hard, sometimes I don't know what to say. There are times when it just doesn't make no sense. But you have been good to me, you have been good to me time and again.
Turning back, now it's time to walk that line. This tassel is gonna turn, but when the moment passes by, we'll just walk away, then slowly grow apart. But I'm not gonna cry, no. I Friday night, football games, first loves and first heartbreaks. It didn't matter who won or lost, only how we played. Memories as good as gold, tearing up those mountain roads. Racing out 53, it's old Georgetown. Sure, we've made a little trouble, but learned from every mistake, so there's no regret. We've done the best we could, so I'm not gonna cry.
As a kid, about 8-9 years old, and
thank you. the official book?
Yes. Okay. Late. Okay. Sorry.
As Student Council President, it is my privilege to welcome all of our staff, administrators, and loved ones who have come out to support my fellow graduates of the class of 2022. Thank you for all that you have done over the years. We would not be sitting here today without your continuous encouragement and support. Standing before you all today, I feel proud and inspired. These past 4 years have flown by. Among our class, we had several state champions, students who have spent countless hours serving our community, and role models who have set an example for Brickview's to come. Although these achievements have been extraordinary, there are several other things worth celebrating. We worked together to create a phenomenal Spirit Week a couple weeks ago, studied relentlessly for tests, and battled for victory. Together, we have persevered through many daunting challenges. The fact that we made it here today is our most outstanding achievement. Our unprecedented high school experience has revealed our true character. Instead of crumbling underneath the stress of the pandemic, we continue to persevere and came out stronger than ever before. Today is not the beginning of our lives, as we have all already written a beautiful beginning to our stories. Today is also not the end, as we all have great potential to do many great things in our futures. There are 323 stories waiting to be written, and we begin the next chapter today. Despite where life takes you, always remember that no matter whether you be near or far, you will always be a Brickie. Thank you, class of 2022.
Would you please stand for the posting of the colors and the singing of the national anthem?
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the
be seated. School board members.
Good evening. I'm Mrs. Carrie Roach, and I'd like to welcome you to this awesome graduation. These kids deserve every bit of applause they're going to get this evening. Yeah. I would like to introduce the Board of Trustees. President of the School Board of Trustees is Mr. Terry Butler. Vice President is Mrs. Ricky Guthrie. Secretary, Mrs. Sandra Hillen. Member, Mr. Frank Porras. Member, Mrs. Karen Robbins. Member, Mr. Donald Rogers. Member, Mr. Stuart Schultz. Student members, Olivia S. Garcia and Morgan Sanchez.
And our other members on stage, Superintendent Dr. Peggy Buffington, Director of Early College and Careers, Ms. Brooke Burchick, Director of Early Learning and Education, Ms. Sarah Gutierrez, Director of Elementary Curriculum and Instruction, Ms. Lori Anderson, Director of Secondary Curriculum and Instruction, Dr. Tim Krieg, Director of Social-Emotional Learning, Mrs. Debbie Mathis, Director of School Counselors, Mr. Matthew Whiteman, Director of Human Resources and Compliance, Mr. John Mock, and our Business Manager, Mr. Robert Glover, Jr., and our Director of Guidance, Danielle Adams. We also would like to welcome our high school administration, Mrs. Colleen Newell, Mr. Craig Osika, our co-principals, our deans of students, Mr. Ty Otherholtz, Tracy Brumley, and Sean Zolatz, athletic director, Mr. Mike Black, and our school counselors, Ms. Shelby Clendaniel, Ms. Victoria Hamilton, Amanda Hensley, Peggy Orchard, our mental health counselor, Ms. Heather Gansky, and our school resource officer, Corporal Monty White. And now to deliver the class president's speech, the class of 22's president, Donovan Ruiz.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the class of 2022, I would like to welcome all faculty, family, alumni, friends, and distinguished guests to our ceremony. It is an honor to be standing here today as class president giving this commencement speech. However, in classic fashion, I did write it yesterday. Graduates, we made it. And to all the moms in the audience, hey, what a crazy 4 years it's been at Hobart High School. From Friday nights at the Brickyard, to state championships, to weird and out there Hobart happenings posts, and to class council impeachment trials, we had a really good time here. It is safe to say that these past 4 years have been extraordinary, filled with excitement, constant Quizlets, and turning things in at 11:59. But I also think I speak for all of us when I say that it is safe to say, but I think I speak for all of us when I say that these 4 years have been one of the absolute craziest times to be alive, especially a high schooler. I want to take you back to March of 2020. It feels like yesterday being a sophomore, excited to have an extra long spring break. Boy, was that a weird time. To all the teachers that taught us over blank black screens as we played video games and slept, thank you. And to the parents who had to deal with us being home, watching us close our Chromebooks and sleep, we thank you for the patience. I would also like to thank the community for everything it's been for me my entire life. Hobart, thank you very much for giving me a home and a place to start this wild journey. I think of those who have built this community to what it is, men like Coach Steve Balish, who inspired generations of students and student athletes with his wisdom and amazing personality as they grew up. To him and to his family, I say thank you. Each generation is defined by the struggles they've endured, and our generation is no stranger to adversity. It has been a very difficult 4 years for many of us here today. I think of the people who are missing a loved one at the dinner table due to COVID-19. I reminisce back to the times when my mother would come home from work after working a hospital and taking care of COVID-positive patients in tears because of what she was witnessing. And COVID-19 was not the only hardship that this generation faced. Besides COVID, there's sadness of thinking about the students at Stoneman Douglas High School who never got to have a ceremony like this. I think of the little boys and girls of Sandy Hook or Uvalde who never got the liberty and experience of growing up or coming back home. I would like to take this time to remember these students and to thank our school resource officers for keeping us safe and the community safe for the past 4 years. There are many problems we face in our world today. And as I look around, I see so many talented, like-minded individuals with dreams and hopes of a better future. I believe that all of us will go on to make the world a better place. Each and every one of us is different and special in our own individual way. Being someone else will never do you any good. We are all champions, champions of our pride and our integrity. And as we venture out of this small town and go our separate ways, remember to stay true to who you really are. Step out of your comfort zone, pursue your dream, and do not settle for anything less. If you have a passion, chase it. If you have a goal, work tirelessly until you accomplish it. Be great in a world full of good. And never let anyone talk you out of being true and loyal to yourself. And I'm going to be honest with you, it's not going to be easy. It's terrifying. It's intimidating moving on from high school into the new chapter of your life. But there's a quote that resonates with me. I don't know exactly where it's from or where I heard it, but I think it'll resonate with all of you too. The quote goes something like this. In this age, and as you move on throughout your life, sometimes you have to be a lion so that you can be the lamb you really are. Be brave and be strong when faced with adversity so that you can truly be yourself. I believe in all of you, and I know that we're all going to do some great things. Class of 2022, thank you.
Thank you, Donovan. And now for the valedictorian speech, Elijah Puente.
When we entered elementary school 12 years ago, this moment seemed like an eternity away. Now, here we are, dressed in these purple and gold gowns, serving as role models for those young Brickies, whether we know it or not. But we could not have done it alone. Families, friends, teachers, and school staff, thank you for your dedication to our success and guidance along the way. Without a doubt, Hobart has some of the most passionate and caring educators and staff out there. I will be forever grateful for all of your contributions to our triumph. Classmates, I will miss you dearly, and I'm thankful to have shared many memorable experiences with all of you through the years, some of which you will not let me live down, like when I threw up during I-Step in fifth grade, which someone actually brought up to me yesterday on Olivia's book. High school is challenging. At times, it forced us outside of our comfort zone, which is an unfamiliar place of existence for many of us. Our decision whether to choose fight or flight in those moments has shaped our perception and our identity. Throughout elementary and middle school, I often chose flight, but I entered high school with a new goal, discovery. I made a commitment to myself freshman year to try something new. I like to swim for fun, you know, do the fun somersaults underwater or whatever. So I thought, why not join swimming? You may do the little somersaults underwater, but it was way more intense than that. Despite the countless belly flops off the starting block, I pushed forward for the next 2 years and continued being the slowest on the team. I may not have learned how to swim fast in my 2 years of swimming, but I learned other valuable lessons. I became comfortable with being uncomfortable. My confidence in my abilities soared, along with my involvement and participation in various extracurriculars. Now, 4 years of grit later, I'm proud to say that I'll be attending an outstanding institution in the fall as a first-generation college student. This is something that seemed so out of reach when I was a little Brickie looking up at the graduating seniors. Class of 2022, I encourage all of you to enter the next portion of your life with a goal of pushing yourself outside of your comfort zone. in the words of Albert Einstein, a ship is always safe at shore, but that is not what it's built for. You will never know what you may find in that vast ocean of discomfort if you do not go explore it. Your dreams are right beneath the surface. All you have to do is jump or belly flop right in.
Thank you, Elijah. And now with a salutatorian speech, Sydney Belk.
In this moment, I really regret not taking our dual credit Ivy Tech speech class. Seeing as how I did not, as I wrote this, I found myself underprepared. So I turned to the place where all high school students look under pressure, WikiHow. And WikiHow told me to include wisdom and honest. And honestly, I don't have any for you because I don't know any more about life than any of you. But rather than leaving you with some quote I found on a Pinterest board, I wish to leave you with a lesson that I hope one day I learn myself. This lesson is in regard to the beloved Hobart slogan, "Be excellent on purpose." Although this slogan is great in its intent, it leaves out the days where you cannot be excellent. There'll be days where you are excellent, when you're at your best and you can give 100% to your excellence. And those days are great. And then there will be days where you fall onto excellence, where you take a shot in the dark and you happen to be excellent. And those days are arguably the best days. And then there will be dark days. Days where excellence is out of reach, where perfection is not possible and compromise is needed. Gwen Stacy has a great take on this in her graduation speech given in The Amazing Spider-Man 2. She states, "It's easy to feel hopeful on a beautiful day like today, but there will be dark days ahead of us too. There will be days where you feel all alone, and that's when hope is needed most. No matter how buried it gets or how lost you feel, you must promise me that you will hold on to hope. Keep it alive. We have to be greater than what we suffer. My wish for you is to become hope. People need that. And even if we fail, what better way is there to live? In closing, I hope that all of you live a life of excellence. Even when you have days that are dark, fail forward. Continue to work towards your excellence. Whether that means a life of excellence found through early through hard work or excellence found late through hard lessons and experiences, I have faith that you will all find it. I've had a great 4 years with you, and I will miss you all very much. Congratulations, 22.
Thank you, Sydney. And now, the student board reps, Olivia S. Garcia and Morgan Sanchez.
Hello, everyone. I'm glad to see all of your faces closer than 6 feet apart. First of all, I would like to thank the board for giving us this amazing opportunity and just invaluable experience. We have learned so much from all of you guys. I am forever grateful. We're graduating. With most of us knowing each other for almost the past 12 years, we'll be facing big changes in the next few months. We can only hope that what we have learned has set us up for greatness, like using Pythagorean theorem, polynomials, knowing that the mitochondria is, you know all that. But really, the relationships we have built here has changed us forever. Before high school, we never knew that Mr. Brumley was a Pokemon Go god. We also never knew that Miss Price lives, loves, and laughs gnomes, or that Mrs. Parrish's eyes light up every time we do a chemistry problem. What we did find out is that our teachers put so much hard work into our education and us. And for that, I would like to give them a big round of applause. To say our high school experience was normal would be a lie, but you all know that. From computer screens to coughing a little bit too hard and feeling the digging stares in the back of your head, we can officially say to our kids, we survived through a pandemic, like our parents explained to us their walk to school. Here at Hobart University, we will forever be remembered, not by popularity, likes, or favorites, but instead by how we treated each other. I hope that all of you have found yourselves just a little bit, and I also hope that you are proud of how you treated others here. When we move away and find out how to be adults, we'll ask ourselves the questions, who do I want to be? What do I stand for? If I eat ramen noodles one more time, will my kidneys fail? We'll have to take ourselves to class, then pay attention in that class, and take a test knowing there will probably not be a curve on the final. It will probably be difficult for all of us, but I know that all of you will find yourselves and be happy with who you are, because that's what the class of 22 is. We have learned to adapt through the unthinkable. And look around you. We made it. Finally, we left our legacy here at Hobart High School. I can't wait to see how you all change and what kind of things you are going to accomplish. I know that my time here has been extraordinary. I'm going to miss all of you so much, and I'm going to beat Mr. Brumley's Pokemon Go. I expect to see all of you at the reunion. Thank you.
I find it amusing that a graduation ceremony is a place where I'm supposed to tell you that individuality is the key to success, regardless of all of us being dressed in identical caps and gowns. But in the fact that I'm supposed to give you life-changing advice in under 3 minutes. But my goal here today is that at least one of you, maybe just one, can leave with at least the slightest change in mind. So today, as cheesy as it is, I'd like to leave you with my best pieces of advice. Number one, be selfish. And I know that's not something you'd expect to hear. I told my dad the same thing, but it's true. Majority of us here are people pleasers, aspiring to do everything right and to always say yes. We don't ask questions, we just say, sure, I can help, or yeah, I don't mind helping, even when we're waist deep in school, extracurriculars, and even work. Do things for yourself and stop being afraid to say no. Join the club you wanted to join, take some time off for a trip, or even buy yourself that new game. We only get this one chance to live our lives, so don't waste it working yourself to death. Number two, stop being satisfied with second place. From this moment forward, you're gonna meet some people you aren't going to like. Maybe it's a lazy boss or a friend you thought would last a lifetime, but no one here deserves to be treated any less than a human being. You have the world in your hands, so stop letting people treat you like garbage. Number three, if you can be anything, be better. Let me ask you, 22, what do you want to be? Psychologists, electricians, soldiers? We've quite the variety, don't we? Even if you don't know, there's still plenty you can do. So if you can't be anything, be better. You never get a chance at this again, and the regret you're gonna live with is unreal. So in the words of my good friend and a fellow classmate, Miss Alicia Parker, stop expecting the world to change, because the change starts with you. Onward and upward, 22.
What a wonderful job by all of our speakers. Thank you so much. And now please welcome the president of the Board of School of Trustees, Mr. Terry Butler.
Thank you. Thank you, students. Thank you for being here and keeping the building together this year. You've had probably one of the most exciting 4 years of high school that I could ever think of, and we appreciate everything you've done. When we started this year, we were debating whether we were going to have the building open or closed. One of your representatives, Morgan, was at a meeting and said, I want to have homecoming, I want to see my friends, I want to have prom. If that means wearing a mask, then I'm in. Here we are. So thank you for following through on that. We made it through. I have something, a little weather report I have to give, just so you know. As you can see, it's not raining in Hobart, but it's raining in Valpo. No. At this time, I try to recognize different groups that we have. And if anyone that's going into the armed service, if they could please rise. If you can stay standing, please. Anyone in the audience that has served in the armed forces, if you could please rise. Thank you. Thank you for your service, and thank you for your future service. We appreciate what you're doing. One other group that has been fighting a fight, and that would be anybody in the medical field. So anybody in the student body that's going into medical field, nursing, technology, whatever in medical, if you could please stand. And the same in the audience. Anyone that's been fighting this battle, please stand. Thank you for all you do and what you will do. I know you'll be successful. And for those of you that are going on to college or going into the trades, we need every one of you. So thank you.
And now with the presentation of the class of 2022, our principals, Ms. Colleen Newell and Craig Osiga.
With the sanction of the State Department of Education of Indiana as an accredited school, the administration and faculty declare that the members of the class of 2022 have met the state and local requirements.
On behalf of the administration and faculty, we wish the class good luck and recommend that they be received with distinction. Congratulations to the class of 2022.
And now with the recognition of college and career credentials, Dr. Peggy Buffington, Daniel Adams, Brooke Burchek, Melanie Leonard, and Dakota Vanderberg.
Good evening. What a perfect night to celebrate Hobart High School's class of 2022. Graduates, as this is your day, I want to thank you for the joy you have brought to so many of us with the spirit of being a true Brickie. Thank you for that. We gather here today to honor you. You've been an outstanding class and have provided incredible leadership to the school city of Hobart and beyond. And at this time, I would like our Director of School Counseling, Mrs. Danielle Adams, and our Director of Early College and Careers, Ms. Brooke Burchek, to recognize the college and career credentials that the class of 2022 has earned.
The graduating class of 2022 has 323 seniors. We would like to recognize their accomplishments in college and careers. We have 211 seniors who have participated in career and technical education, taking 4 to 6 credits in a CTE sequence. There are a total of 250 graduates receiving early college credits. Of those 250 seniors, 173 have earned 15 or more college credits while in high school. Throughout their 4 years of high school, the class of 2022 have earned 7,582 college credits with a total savings of $1,283,738.56. Students who have earned early college credit or completed a CTE sequence are wearing a gold stole tonight. At this time, please stand and be recognized. Oh, yeah.
We have students completing the Indiana College Corps, which is a 30-credit sequence that will transfer to public universities in Indiana as 1 year of college. This year, we have 15 students completing this credential. At this time, if you are wearing a white hood, please stand and be recognized as completing the Indiana College Corps. We also have 44 seniors who are earning their associate's degree this school year, which means they will leave Hobart High School with both a high school diploma and a 2-year college degree. At this time, if you are wearing a gold hood, please stand and be recognized as completing an associate's degree. All of these students earning the Indiana College Corps or an associate's degree will be recognized when their name is called to receive their diploma. You will hear their name followed by the credential they have earned. Congratulations, class of 2022, on your accomplishments.
You are definitely an amazing class. Class of 2022, you have accomplished so much, as we've just heard. We couldn't be prouder of you. Speaking on behalf of your class about the opportunities you have achieved and what it all means, joining me on the stage will be Dakota Vanderberg and Melanie Leonard.
Usually when I'm on this field, there's a screaming student section, sweaty football players, and a lot of frantic coaches running around. But today, I love seeing all of your amazing faces on this field. To start out, I want to give a huge congratulations to the class of 2022. You're all so amazing, and not to boost your own egos or anything, but I think this is one of the most athletically, artistically, and academically gifted classes Hobart has ever seen. I have the honor of speaking on behalf of Hobart University tonight, which is our partnership with Ivy Tech. When I think of Hobart University, the word that comes to mind is opportunity. It's the opportunity to excel and prove that we are college and career ready. This opportunity is also very unique to our area, and not all schools in Indiana have it. This was a topic of discussion I've had with countless out-of-town relatives, and every time I bring up Hobart University, they're blown away. Besides that, I also see Hobart University as a safety net. Growing up in a family that experienced a member having cancer at the young age of 15, I saw how they say, life happens, and it can set you back. So when you receive a technical certificate, a college credit, or even a degree from Hobart University, you build your own safety net. So if life happens, many of us are fortunate enough to have something to fall back on. Myself, for example, I'll be graduating with my CNA certification along with an associate's degree in general studies, so I'd be able to support myself, even if my college career gets put on hold. Not to mention, these achievements also made me stand out in the crowd of college applicants when applying to schools, allowing me to get into prestigious private and public universities like many of you here today. These credits and programs also open the door for our students in industries that build Northwest Indiana, such as construction, NIPSCO, the automotive industry, and many more. Without them, we wouldn't really even be here. With these programs showing us what it's like to be in college or the workforce, I'm sure we will all excel in any path we choose to take and make a lasting impact. To close, I wish you all the best in any path that you may take. And I would like to thank Dr. Buffington, the guidance department, admin, and all of our lovely and talented teachers for making this opportunity a reality. And to Ms. Burchek and Ms. Adams, sorry about all the emails I sent you about this. But in closing, I'm so proud of you all, and I know we will leave a lasting impact here at Hobart High School. Thank you.
Hello. They really let me speak in front of all you guys. This is crazy. Though most of you may know me, for those of you who don't, my name is Dakota Vanderberg. I was asked to speak today on the benefits and tremendous opportunities offered through Ivy Tech and Hobart University. Even saying the word tremendous is an understatement of how beneficial the programs offered actually are. Take a moment, look around at the number of graduates, including myself, who are wearing a golden hood, early college or CTE stoles, and even the green cords. All of these are symbols representing early college, representing a doorway to greater opportunity. I myself am graduating with an associate's degree, which will allow me to effectively eliminate most of, if not all of, my gen ed courses, providing me a more career-focused post-secondary education study that saves time, saves money, and allows for the pursuit of more diversified studies. My experience in attaining that degree was one of change and finding what I truly wanted to be in life. I started wanting to be an engineer and ended wanting to become an educator. Even though my aspirations changed, I was still able to slot classes to benefit me going into college, and I was still able to attain my associate's degree. Whether or not the credentials, certification, or degree is a direct match for whatever career you decide to pursue, it is a distinction of yourself in only a positive way and will give you a foot in the door to opportunities you choose to pursue. Now, I know we all want to make this go quickly, so I'll wrap this up. I would just like to display some gratitude to those that helped along the way. Of course, a thank you to Ivy Tech and their partnership, as well as the administration for the implementation of their curriculum within our own. A thank you to the guidance department. Without the advisement and well-structured but flexible plans that each counselor provides, there would be little to no students who would be able to truly understand the benefits of dual credit classes, certification pathways, and degree earning possibilities. A thank you to the teachers, who not only provided a rigorous and educational learning experience within the classroom, but also for providing spaces of socialization, emotional reprieve, and all-around enjoyment. I myself aspire to be a teacher who can be as helpful and aware as all of you, and you have set the perfect example not only for myself, but for all aspiring educators. Now, most importantly, a thank you to my peers. You are what makes Hobart University. The bright minds are filled with ingenuity, intelligence, and innovation. A class filled with athletes and scholars, many of whom will use the opportunities provided to break the barriers set by those before them. No road is too long, no wall is too high to climb. No success is too small. Tonight we celebrate our success, and congratulations to us, the class of 2022. Thank you.
Thank you.
And with the acceptance of the class of 2022, Dr. Peggy Buffington.
All right, that is truly amazing. And it is evident that our graduates, after this evening, we will be honored to call you distinguished alumni of Hobart High School. On this wonderful occasion, it's important to acknowledge the educators, parents, and family members who have helped you arrive at this point in your lives. I know you've thanked them, but we can't thank them enough. The stadium is filled with people that are just so proud of you and celebrating you tonight. Can you please give a round of applause for your family, your parents, and teachers who have brought you to this point in your life? In your 4 years of high school, we have all learned monumental ways of living and life. Change is automatic. Change happens whether we like it or not. Change demands adjustments and growth. Growth requires planning, strategies, and focused effort. Growth has to be intentional by every individual. You must choose to be excellent on purpose. As Bricky leaders, you have delivered. Graduates, continue to grow by investing in yourself. As John Maxwell eloquently stated, growth is the only guarantee that tomorrow is going to be better. You have the reins now. Lead us into the best future yet. Bricky up, keep growing and investing in yourself. As you transition into this new journey of life, see your life as a mission to impact as many lives as positively as you can. The difference you make tomorrow begins with the decisions you make today. May your good example of character, work, and relationships influence many lives with an impact that is far-reaching and long-lasting. Your mission of impact and making a difference in life requires hard work. That oh-so-famous Bricky saying, "All my life, I want to be a Bricky. Work, work, work." It's so true. It takes hard work to get ahead. Nothing is out of your reach if you remember that. Along the way, be grateful for all of the blessings of life. Do something every day to show compassion and generosity to others. Love sacrificially, and I guarantee it will be returned. On this new road that you pursue, do not forget that this is your home. And we are here for you. You are a Bricky. Once a Bricky, always a Bricky. And now, on behalf of the state of Indiana, the Board of School Trustees, our administrative faculty, your teachers from kindergarten through 12th grade, the support staff, and the entire community of the School City of Hobart who have dedicated themselves to your education, I, as Superintendent of Schools, proudly accept and confirm you, Class of 2022. Congratulations.
And now with the presentation of diplomas, the School Board of Trustees, Danielle Adams, Tracy Brumley, Sean Zolatz, Craig Osika, Colleen Newell, and Mr. Arthur Holtz. And we do ask that as the graduates are receiving their diploma, if you please remain in your seats so that everybody can see their graduate and no one is prevented from doing so. Thank you very much.
Row one, please rise. At this time, we will read the names of the graduates. Luke S. Abbott.
Aisha M. Arias, magna cum laude.
Sydney E. Anderson, Indiana College Corps, magna cum laude.
Jasmine Arroyo.
Sydney D. Arias, magna cum laude.
Tony Marie Baltima.
Nicholas A. Arredondo.
Nicholas P. Batalis.
Ivan A. Balboa.
Taye J. Battle.
Alexander J. Batalis.
Jediah Belk.
Ashton Battistella.
Aaron M. Bell.
McKenna D. Beck.
Gregory S. Bell.
Sydney M. Belk, summa cum laude.
Ariana G. Bergman.
Gregory Marcus Bell.
Gwyneth Burzak.
Justice C. Beller.
Brandon Bloom.
Mason R. Berry.
Connor J. Bach.
Brooke A. Blanchard, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Jesse J. Botkin.
Madison M. Blowers.
Isabel M. Broski.
Rhiannon P. Borowski, Associate of General Studies.
Emily R. Burgess.
Jonathan D. Bradbury.
Cameron Bird.
Madison L. Bunch.
Naisha L. Calderon.
Cameron Olivia Butterfield.
Bobby Cameron.
Jaden Nicholas Camacho.
Giovanni E. Cardona, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
At this time, row one, you may be seated. Row two, please rise. Isabella R. Soselski.
Braden M. Carlson, cum laude.
Courtney S. Carey, Indiana College Corps, magna cum laude.
Leela A. Castro.
Renice I. Carrillo, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Riley Chalmers.
Yanexis Castro Rivera.
Chelsea A. Chavez, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Gage Catlin.
Mattresson!
Dominique Clemens.
Bridget C. Chavez, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Aoife Combs, Associate of Arts and Liberal Arts, summa cum laude.
Matthew Scott Shervin, Associate of Applied Science in Energy Technology.
Jennifer B. Cooper.
Christiana Clark.
Ethan C. Cover, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Caden D. Click, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Alexia A. Quadra.
Samuel A. Coombs, Indiana College Corps, cum laude.
Landon A. Curiel.
Tyler Jackson Corbeil, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Devon A. Dickerson.
Madeline J. Cruz.
Mickey Jankovich.
Angel E. Quavez, Indiana College Corps.
Amaria J. Donald.
Nicholas L. Delgado.
Catherine R. Downs, magna cum laude.
Shane Dinelli.
Woo! Daniel Day Dumovich.
I have one quick correction. Nicholas L. Delgado graduated cum laude. Ariel Renee Domsick.
Destiny Paige Durbin.
Willard A. DePiriak.
Mark D. Enslin.
Nicole L. Drapak, Indiana College Corps, summa cum laude.
Jeffrey C. Fay.
Aaron R. Dunn, cum laude.
Ethan R. Ferba, cum laude.
Row two, please be seated. Row three, please rise. Jason Emard.
Jaden M. Pfeiffer.
Emmanuel D. Earl.
Angelica Flores.
Haley Feeler, Associate of General Studies.
Jalen Foster.
Logan Federick.
Gabrielle Frazier.
Skylar A. Pfeiffer.
Michaela J. Fuentes.
Ryan A. Flores.
Hoku Garcia Guerrero.
Madison L. Fraze, Indiana College Corps.
Olivia M. Garcia, magna cum laude.
Ian A. Freimuth, Associate of General Studies.
Natalie A. Gayton.
Ivan Garcia.
Mason J. Gnidic.
Olivia S. Garcia. Cum laude.
Alexis Renee Griffith.
Reginald K. Gilbert, Indiana College Corps, cum laude.
Matthew J. Gully.
Alyssa Gonzalez.
Francisco Gutierrez.
Keon Lee Griffin.
Antonio Guzman.
Andrea Gutierrez, Associate of General Studies.
Hannah R. Hannenkrat.
Anna Guzman.
Damian C. Harmonak, magna cum laude.
Travis M. Hajek.
Haley Y. Hashu.
Lucas Hanrahan.
Emma M. Hendricks, Indiana College Corps.
Jaden Hence.
Samuel S. Henson.
Tyler C. Henry.
Alexis J. Hibbs.
Row 3, please be seated. Row 4, please rise. Julian Hernandez.
Peyton E. Holdorf.
Yasmin M. Hillsberg.
Chase R. Hamaki.
Megan Grace Hill.
Evan R. Horn.
Ashton A. Holmes.
Kaylin Joe Hubbard.
Amy M. Hooker, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Victoria J. Hughes.
Megan Kathleen Horn, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Jacob M. Irizarry.
Amelia Marie Huerta.
Aaron R. Jackson.
Reginald G. Hunter.
Jonathan G. James.
Chloe M. Isaac.
Yeah. Jayla L. Johnson.
Dior Jackson.
Sean Michael Johnson.
Madeline C. Jelinek. Magna cum laude.
Nicholas B. Juris.
Kira Johnson.
Emily E. Casper.
Timothy A. Johnson.
Emily C. Kerr.
Demetrios M. Karagiannakis.
Kamari J. Knox.
Ethan Duane Ray James Keown, Associate of General Studies.
Georgios V. Coxides.
Shayna L. Knight, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Daniel R. Kunopasek.
Ethan E. Knox.
Nicholas D. Kruger.
Yelena Kalungia, Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts, magna cum laude.
Brandon Alexander Lane, cum laude.
Jacob B. Kudapasik.
Alexandria Lavelle.
Row 4, please be seated. Row 5, please rise.
Makes sense.
Jamie N. Landrum, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Colin C. Lair.
Mihailo Latinovich.
Brittany A. Lazinski.
Matthew H. Letterman.
Piper Grace Logan.
Melanie K. Leonard, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Eris Avori Lopez, Associate of General Studies, cum laude.
Jillian Elizabeth Lockard.
Amber S. McRoberts, summa cum laude.
Jake Thomas Long.
Hayden X. Maggio.
Eduardo Macias.
Jacob Constantino Marqueda, magna cum laude.
Vincent J. Magana.
Chandler Martin.
Nathaniel Mamouche.
Ilana D. Mata.
Frank Maravich.
Kashmir E. Mall.
Eduardo Jesus Martinez, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Joseph P. Mahar, Indiana College Corps, cum laude.
Hannah Karen Sky Mathis.
Jason L. Mejia.
Leah Guadalupe Matofo.
Brisa Ruby Merced.
Jared A. Medeiros.
Savannah Marie Merritt.
Mario A. Mendoza.
Gabriel Christian Morellis.
Addison M. Merrill.
Lizbeth Moreno.
Anthony Miller.
Autumn Chantel Muir.
Andres Morales.
Brian Muniz.
Dale Charles Mossman.
Ella Rose Navarro.
Row 5, you may be seated. Row 6, please rise. Riley R. Mummy.
Emma K. Novak, magna cum laude.
Candace R. Myers, Indiana College Corps.
Matthew R. O'Connell, Associate of Science and Liberal Arts, magna cum laude.
Gabrielle L. Nikolic.
Lillian B. O'Rourke.
Brett M. Nuzzo, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Charlize M. Otero, Associate of General Studies.
Melissa O'Keefe.
Miranda Rochelle Palka.
Jaden G. Ochoa.
Peyton Marie Peek.
Alexis N. Paisley, Associate of General Studies.
Jose Perez.
Alasia Parker.
Samantha Porosky.
Anthony David Perez.
Paige Ryan Petzl, Associate of General Studies.
Ryan A. Perez.
Elena E. Pierce.
Alexander M. Pickett, Indiana College Corps, magna cum laude.
Abriana L. Piontek.
Jasmine Pimentel.
Alyssa Renee Puente.
Ariana Ponce. Ariana Ponce.
Joshua Pulsifer.
Elijah J. Puente, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Kyle Rader III.
Dulce Marie Rabanon, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Emma M. Ramirez, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Michael A. Ramirez, Indiana College Corps.
Hunter A. Rands.
Caitlin Sierra Riggs.
Hayden Michael Ring.
Calvin Ulysses Rios.
Carissa L. Rourke, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Sylvester T. A. Rodriguez.
Olivia A. Rosales.
Row 6, please be seated. Row 7, please rise. Rosenbaum.
Logan D. Ross.
Kirsten Rotz.
Donovan X. Ruiz, Associate of General Studies.
Alexandra Runk.
Devin Saklak, Associate of Science and Liberal Arts, cum laude.
Leonidas Salpagithi.
Morgan O. Sanchez, Associate of General Studies, summa cum laude.
Diego M. Sanchez.
Jacob Sapper.
Madison Lynn Santillan.
Lindsay A. Schallenkamp.
Justin R. Sawyer.
Trevor Shamert.
Morgan E. Schallenkamp.
Adriana R. Serrano.
Madeline Pearl Schulatz.
Malachi A. Sharif.
Gabriella Furnacious.
Samuel Shockley.
Madison Schinkel, Indiana College Corps.
Jacob L. Simpson.
Julia C. Sierra.
Jonathan R. Skomak.
Isabella K. Scalba.
Paige J. Solovice.
Liliana M. Slavo.
Anna Rose Stefaniak.
Tiana Spencer.
Haley A. Strickland.
Carmine Stengel, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Ethan J. Tsai, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Torrance D. Strickland.
Joshua Ricardo Tejeda, Indiana College Corps, cum laude.
Katie R. Stroh.
Kirsten Elizabeth Tinoco.
Julian J. Tamayo.
Christopher A. Trezak, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Row 7, please be seated. Row 8, please rise. Tabercho.
Dakota E. Vanderberg, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Walter Todd, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
magna cum laude.
Antonio R. Vargas.
Autumn C. Turley.
Aiden J. Ward, Associate of General Studies, magna cum laude.
Ty Van.
Jenna M. Wagaman.
Eric Angel Vasquez.
Jonah H. Wells.
Julie Antoinette Washington.
Elijah Wilson.
Vanessa True Waymeyer.
Anna Marie Wood.
Anthony Williams.
Jalen Marie Youngberg.
Ruby Ann Wynn, Associate of General Studies.
Jamie L. Zimbicki, cum laude.
Janaya Renee Woods, Indiana College Corps.
Caleb Sanchez.
Miguel R. Zepeda.
Felicita Angel Marie De Jesus.
Maggie G. Zimbicki, Associate of General Studies.
Cadence Luis Cates.
Kendall Ralph.
Rebecca M. Anderson.
Seated.
Now that your years of high school are over, it is time for you to travel into your adult life with curiosity, determination, intention, integrity, happiness, hope, and gratitude.
Curiosity about the choices before you and the people you will meet and the places you will go. Set your expectations high and work to achieve them.
Determination to live well. Maintain optimism in the face of adversity and to treat others the way you want to be treated.
Intention to remember that manners count for much in life and help you build bridges as you network yourself thoughtfully through your relationships.
Integrity, the big word for being honest and doing the right thing, even when no one is watching.
Happiness in who you are and will become. Spread happiness to others, but know when you cannot make everybody happy, you can choose to be happy with everyone.
Hope. If you only carry one thing through life, let it be hope that better things are always ahead and that you can get through the toughest of times because you are stronger than any challenge that may come your way. Hope to remain on the path to where you are meant to be, because during these times, hope will be the very thing that carries you through.
And gratitude for the ability to embrace change and to celebrate victories, yours and those of others around you. Thankfulness for achieving your high school education and knowing that you are going forward now into your future. Be grateful for those who have helped you along the way, and for those who will be there one day or when you need them most. Thank you, class of 2022, for 4 years. Cheers to years of adventure.
Next, we will have the singing of the Alma Mater by Wolfgang under the direction of Dean Wolf, and the playing of the class song.
I can't sit and stand back up again.
Hail, all hail, Hobart High School, we students true. Pledge thee our love and give support to you. In loss or victory, we sing your praises high.
To dress up like hipsters and make fun of our exes. It feels like a perfect night for breakfast at midnight to fall in love with strangers. Yeah, we're happy, free, confused, and lonely at the same time. It's miserable and magical. Oh yeah, tonight's the night when we forget about the deadlines, it's time.
Oh,
teachers, I wanted to make you aware that there is a lovely balloon display for the class of 22. It is a gift from the student council and from the theater department, and hopefully you'll be able to take a picture with your family back there. Now, my favorite time of the evening. Please stand. Take your tassels, move them across to your heart. On the count of three, get ready. One, two, three. Thank you for joining us. Have a wonderful evening.
Seniors, please turn in your gowns. That's where you will get your diplomas.